Hey guys, today we're going to look at a very simple ThinkCell trick, which is setting two charts to the same scale so we can easily compare across both of them. So I've set up two charts in PowerPoint that I built with ThinkCell. On the left hand side you can see Acme Toolco, on the right hand side Jones Tooling. When you first look at the charts, it looks like they're showing the exact same thing, including the exact same data. And the reason for that is because the scales are not set the same. In fact, Jones Tooling is exactly double what Acme Toolco is. So as a reader, when you look at this, you don't immediately understand the relativity or the difference between Acme and Jones. What we need to do is we need to set the scales to be the same. There's a couple of ways to do this. The first one is manual. So you click on the axis and you can drag the axis extent up to 80 million. And then the axes are now equal. And now you can see that Jones Tooling is a much more successful business, at least in revenue terms, than Acme Toolco. Setting it manually like this has an issue. And that issue is if we change some of the data, so maybe we add a new year in and it goes higher. Now the axis has changed for Jones, but it hasn't changed for Acme, so it's off again. Now we can continue to update manually and that will work fine. But better than that, what we can actually do is we can automatically set the scales to be equal. And what that means is when the axis changes on one, the axis will automatically change on the other to set them consistently. So to do that, we hold Control and click on both of the axes, right click, and there's a button here that says Set Same Scale. Click on that, and now you'll see that the scale for Acme is the same as the scale for Jones. And obviously it's very easy to see the difference between the two businesses. The important thing about this is that if I do change the data in Jones, you can see it's turned to 100 million. It's also updated Acme to change to 100 million as well. And no matter what happens to the data, the two axes will always stay the same. And that's the beauty of this tool. Now I'm going to show you how to remove the link between the two axes. Again, you highlight both of them, you right click, and you click on the button that says reset to independent scale. And now it's updated to the default scales. One thing I want to show you now is about axis breaks. Let's imagine that we have an axis break in Jones Tooling. So I'm going to add an axis break here. And you can see that it's added an axis break automatically at the top. I might just update that to look a little nicer. Now, what happens when we set the scales to be the same when there's an axis break on one of the charts? What happens is that it automatically adds the axis break to the other chart. So no matter what happens to the axes, they always remain consistent. So that's it. That's how you set the same axis in ThinkCell. Now, before we finish up, just one more reminder, please subscribe to get PowerPoint and ThinkCell tips and tutorials, things you didn't even know that you wanted, but turn you into a power user. Thanks very much.